Hey everyone! We've got another JunosOS release with some exciting key features to share with you. Let's get started with the new routing and switching features to learn more. We now support BGP Classful Transport with underlying transport as colored SRTE tunnels. You can also use BGP CT to resolve service routes using the transport ribs and to compute the next hop. No need to tear down a session. Improve your efficiency using the new options to drop or hide excess routes in the existing BGP peers. Enable the Performance Monitoring Responder functionality without enabling the transmission of continuity check messages. Packet-based mobile backhaul networks perform better, with operators now able to synchronize services. ACX2100 and ACX2200 now support Precision Time Protocol over Ethernet encapsulation and G.8275.1 telecom profiles. Preempt secondary label switch paths that are signaled but inactive. Configure the hold priority of the secondary standby LSPs for RSVP traffic engineering, with 0 being the highest priority and 7 the lowest. ACX710 routers now support BGP Multicast VPNs, also known as Next Generation MVPN. You can configure multi-point LDP provider tunnels as the data plane for intra-AS BGP MVPNs. Use Juniper Agile Licensing to simplify and centralize license installation, deployment, and administration for hardware and software features on the listed EX series devices. Now for the key features on the security side. You can deploy next-gen capabilities of the CSRX Container Firewall using Amazon Elastic Kubernetes Service. This fully managed service offers IDP in combination with the CSRX versatility and the agility provided by Elastic IaaS. VSRX 3.0 instances that you deploy on VMware and kernel-based virtual machines now support the Mellanox ConnectX-4 and ConnectX-5 adapters. Instances deployed on kernel-based virtual machines now support single-root I/O virtualization on Intel E810 series 100 gigabit Ethernet adapters. The Show Security Policies Hit Count command output now displays a policy's utility rate based on dynamic application and URL category hit numbers. You can now use ExpressPath Plus to automatically offload all the eligible sessions to the ASIC network processors. SRX series devices can also disable a session's unneeded TCP proxy plugin based on user-defined configurations or by the state of the flow. Configure the MRU size on SRX series devices to accept packet sizes that are bigger than the configured MTU size. We've upgraded SSL proxy to support Transport Layer Security version 1.3. This upgrade reduces the SSL round trip time to 1 per full handshake and to 0 for resumptions. We now support firewall user authentication in a unified security policy with dynamic applications. Configure a policy pass-through or a web authentication method to restrict or permit users' access to network resources. All right, thanks for tuning in. Be sure to head over to the Tech Library for more information about these key features and other release details.